Hey, what's up guys? My name is Josh and today I'm going to show you the difference between balanced and unbalanced audio signals. So typically I don't go this in depth into things, but I think this topic is really cool. But before I get into the meat and potatoes of all of it, here's what I want you to take away from today. Balanced audio signals slash cables will give you a better, stronger, and cleaner signal between your devices. By cleaner, I mean without any noise or interference. Okay, now time for the meat and potatoes. This is an unbalanced quarter inch TS audio cable. The fact that it's unbalanced means that as the audio signal goes down the line, it's susceptible to picking up noise and interference. There are two wires inside an unbalanced cable, a signal wire, which carries the signal, and a ground wire, which acts as a reference point for the signal. However, the ground wire also acts like an antenna, and it can pick up unwanted noise along the way. So where does this noise come from? Most commonly, it comes from power cables laying all over the place, which can add noise if they're within proximity or touch the audio cables. Other cables can add noise too, along with stage lighting like older spotlights and dimmers. So because they're so susceptible to noise, unbalanced cables typically don't run over 25 feet. Here's a quick tip though, if you have to run unbalanced audio cables by power cables, don't run them parallel, have them cross at one perpendicular point. That's a much better way to do it. Two commonly used unbalanced cables are TS and RCA cables. TS stands for tip sleeve. The tip connects to the signal wire we talked about, and the sleeve connects to the ground wire. Okay, let's move on to balanced signals. With balanced audio, there's less risk for noise because there's three wires in the cable. You have the same ground wire, but you also have two copies of the same signal, known as a hot or positive signal and a cold or negative signal. These two signals have their polarity reversed, so they actually cancel each other out until they get to the input device. Then the polarity of the cold or negative signal is flipped back to positive to match the hot signal. Why is this important? Because if noise is added to the signals, when the cold signal flips back in polarity, the positive noise on the cold signal also flips in polarity, canceling out with the noise added to the hot signal. And boom, no more noise. This is why balanced signals are preferred, especially when running them long distances. Commonly used balanced cables are XLR and TRS, which stands for tip, ring, sleeve. Just like the TS cable, you can tell a balanced cable by its connectors as well. Both XLR and TRS cables have connector for the ground, hot, and cold wires. Well, that's about it. I hope you had as much fun with this as I did. If you want to learn a little more in depth about balanced and unbalanced audio, you can click on the blog post in the description below. If you have any questions or you just want to say hi, let me know in the comments below. I'm going to show you the garage door effect now.